Welcome to my secret place devotion with Oyiks Alfred. The Word of God is alive and equipped to change your life.
Good morning. The Bible says that God will guide us and that He will lead us, He will advise us. But let us pray about it and ensure that this will be our experience today. That's from Psalm 32 verse 8. So Father, we thank you so much for promising that you will guide us, my Father. I pray for everyone that is connected today, Lord, that you guide us, you advise us, you provide counsel, Lord, and you watch over us, Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for hearing and answering in Jesus' name. Amen. You know, Jesus made a very interesting statement in John chapter 14 verse 10. He says, "Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words I speak are not my own, but my Father who lives in me does his work through me." Now, it's interesting because Jesus is trying to communicate here that every single thing that he did, all the works that he did, it wasn't really him doing it. It was the Spirit of God that's living on his inside. He's the one that was doing all the works. That is what Jesus was trying to communicate, because he said, you know, the Father that lives in me, that's talking about the Holy Spirit, is the one doing the work through me. In other words, Jesus was trying to explain to us his total dependence on the person called the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit, Jesus would not have been able to function here on earth. Remember, he was God, but he came as a man, limited in the flesh. So the ability and all the things that he did were because of the Holy Spirit. He really depended so heavily on the Holy Spirit. So the works he was doing was through the Holy Spirit. The Bible tells us from his birth, that's the incarnation, the Holy Spirit was there. Remember in Luke chapter 1 verse 35, when the angel came to Mary, said, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you and the power of the Most High shall overshadow you. And for that reason, the holy offspring shall be called the Son of God." So in other words, it is the Holy Spirit that walked through the body of Mary to birth Jesus Christ. So from his birth, you will see the Holy Spirit there. When he grew up, of course, during baptism, when he was baptized by John the Baptist, you see again the Holy Spirit coming like a dove upon him. Throughout his entire ministry, you see the Holy Spirit working very closely with Jesus to get the job done. Now, the beautiful thing about it is that Jesus also left us in the hand of the Holy Spirit. And we have access to the Holy Spirit because of Jesus, because we are his children. The same Holy Spirit that Jesus had access with, the same Holy Spirit that we have. And you know, the best way I can describe the Holy Spirit is that he's a bundle of gifts. There are so many things that the Holy Spirit comes to do in the life of a believer. Let's take, for instance, if you look at John chapter 16 verse 13, the Bible says, "When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth. He will not speak of his own, but will tell you what he has heard. He will tell you about the future." So in this verse of scripture, the Bible says that, you know, whenever you want to understand truth, the person to ask is the Holy Spirit, because it said he will guide us into all truth, meaning that when you're studying the Word of God, you need to ask for the help of the Holy Spirit. He will guide you to explain and understand the scripture and to help you to experience the things that you're reading about. So for instance, if God has promised a particular thing, you need to ask the Holy Spirit, "Guide me into the truth of this. Explain the scripture to me." Again, in that same verse, the Bible says that the Holy Spirit will tell us about the future. So one of the things the Holy Spirit does is to open your eyes, to alert you about something that is to come, whether it is good or bad, so that you're able to prepare. That's why one of the things you need to say, "Holy Spirit, if there's anything I need to know about my future, please show me what it is," so that, you know, sometimes you need information about what's going on in the future so that you can circumvent them. Maybe you can avoid them or you can go for them. That's part of what the Holy Spirit does. And you have access to the ministry of the Holy Spirit because it is one of your rights and privileges, or what you call your inheritance as a child of God. One other thing that the Holy Spirit actually does is to empower you on the inside. When you are down, you're broken on the inside, you're confused, you can ask for the strengthening of the Holy Spirit on the inside. The Bible tells us in Ephesians chapter 3 verse 16, he says, "I pray that from his glorious unlimited resources, he will empower empower you with inner strength through His Spirit. So there's something called inner strength, and you need inner strength to function. If you don't have inner strength, eventually your external strength, you know, will be weak. So you need inner strength. Whenever you're feeling tired on the inside, whenever you're feeling discouraged, whenever you feel, I can't take this anymore, what you need to do is ask that the Holy Spirit will quicken your inner man, give you inner strength. If you're even ill or something, you can ask the Holy Spirit, give me inner strength to be able to go through this. Whatever it is, you know, that you need on the inside, you can say, Holy Spirit, strengthen me on the inside. Are you discouraged? Ask Him to strengthen you on the inside. And His job is to supply strength to you, because that's just what the Holy Spirit does. So there are so many things He does. If you read your Bible in John 14:16, He says, I will ask the Father, He will give you another helper who will be with you forever. Just read it from the God's Word translation. They call the Holy Spirit the helper. So do you need help in any area? Just reach out to the Holy Spirit. It's your right as a child of God. Don't struggle and suffer alone. Let me end by telling you this story. So there was this man and his son. They were going somewhere, you know, along the road. They met this very, very big giant stone. Like, I'll call that a rock. A really big rock across the road. And so the son tells the father, you know what, let me push the rock aside. So the son goes, he tries to push the rock aside. He struggles. He's not able to. He goes to take a big wood and try to lift the rock. He refused. He used his back to move the rock. He refused. He used his hands to move the rock. He refused. He did everything. And then when he got tired, he went to the father and said, Dad, I've tried everything and the rock is still not moving. The dad said, no, you've not tried everything. And so the boy went again, tried everything, pushed, pulled, did everything. It wasn't working. He came back to the father and said, Dad, I've tried every single thing, but the rock is just not moving. And the father replied again, you haven't tried everything. And so, of course, the boy went back the third time, tried again, he didn't succeed, came back. So when the father now repeated the same thing again, you haven't tried everything, the son decided to ask the father, okay, so tell me, what haven't I tried? The father simply said, you haven't asked me to help you. And that is exactly how we relate to the Holy Spirit. We have issues, we have problems, we need help, but we run around asking every other person, doing every other thing, and those things don't work. Have you ever sat down and said, Holy Spirit, please help me? It is your right. It is your privilege. It is your inheritance as a child of God to get the help of the Holy Spirit. The reason you're not getting the help of the Holy Spirit is that you have not asked Him. And if you study the ministry of the Holy Spirit, you understand that until you request for His help, He will not step in. The Holy Spirit is a gentleman. He doesn't force Himself on somebody. He doesn't interfere except you actually invite Him to take charge of that particular situation, or you directly ask Him to help you. Then you will see Him help you. So is there something going wrong in your life and you've tried to do it by power and by might? Well, why don't you stop and just simply say, Holy Spirit, help me. And you see the incredible help of God, and you not believe how that help will come. But I can assure you that the Holy Spirit is our helper, and He can hear you when you sincerely cry out to Him and say, just help me, and He will bring help. Thank you so much for listening. God bless you.
My help has come.
For other life-changing messages, you can now download the app Rev Oyiks Speaks from Play Store for Android phone users or Apple Store for iOS users. You can also follow us on Instagram, YouTube, and Telegram, all on the handle Oyiks Alfred.